Fournette. Fournette goes airborne. He's in. Touchdown, Jaguars.
Tip and intercepted by Ramsey to close it out.
It's over. The Jacksonville Jaguars have pulled off the upset of the playoffs.
What is going on, everybody? It is Treep from Treep Talks here. Back with a little bit of a breaking news piece. Today, the Jacksonville Jaguars named their five captains for the 2018 season. It's a good thing they brought that today because I was kind of struggling for a video idea on this Monday. But here we go. So, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, I am Tree from BigJReport.com, and these are the five captains for the Jacksonville Jaguars for the 2018 season. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, let's kick things off first with the defensive captains for the Jags this season. Let's start off with veteran linebacker now, Telvin Smith. Telvin Smith has really filled the Paul Posluszny leader role on the defense. So I think as of right now, that's not really a surprise. Telvin Smith, definitely a leader in the locker room. Somebody that, you know, the defense looks up to. You know, these young linebackers that are trying to make their way into the league, I'm sure, look at Telvin Smith as more of a role model. So congratulations to Telvin Smith for getting that captain role, something that I think he truly deserves. And speaking of a guy that a lot of people look up to and a guy that deserves a captain title, Calais Campbell is also going to be named a Jaguar captain. He's the oldest guy on the team, I do believe, and I think, you know, just with that experience and leadership, definitely deserving of that defensive captain role. Definitely, you know, guys like Yannick Ngakoue, Dante Fowler, I'm sure those guys are all looking up to Calais Campbell. The leadership ability, I believe he was the captain when he was playing for Arizona back in the day. And, you know, to come here and now be a captain for the Jags is a big deal. I think Telvin Smith was the captain last year, but I don't think Calais was, because I think that was, you know, because that was his first season with the Jags. So, you know, after having that explosive year coming in and being a captain, that is a huge deal. And the final defensive captain, which is kind of surprising to me, is Laurente McCray. I don't know if they're really kind of trying to go for like maybe a special teams captain, and that's what McCray is. But however, Laurente McCray got the captain position, which is the most shocking one, in my opinion, was McCray getting a captain. I'm not saying he doesn't deserve it necessarily, but he's the guy that's not going to be on the field very much. So maybe that is true. Maybe he's more of just a special teams captain, which is something that I could see. So, Laurente McCray, congratulations on your captain role here for our boys, the Jacksonville Jaguars. And now let's go over to some offensive captains. For the second or third year in a row, I believe, Brandon Linder has been named a captain. He's been one of our better offensive linemen, our best offensive linemen, for the last 2 or 3 years. But now we brought in, obviously, Andrew Norwell, who's an all-pro guard and, you know, is one of the best offensive linemen in the league. So maybe Brandon Linder's going to have to take a step back for Norwell to be the best lineman on the team. However, Linder's not too far behind. He's a leader. He's a great offensive lineman and, you know, a great captain and a great selection to be a captain for the Jags. This one I was a little surprised about, not because his play doesn't deserve it, but because, you know, I don't think the Jags have had a running back captain since Maurice Jones-Drew, and that is Leonard Fournette. So the bell cow of the Jags offense ended up getting the title of a captain. So congratulations to Leonard Fournette, who's obviously going to be 75% of the Jags offense next year. So definitely truly deserving, Leonard Fournette. And his second year for the Jags is going to be a captain. So has the big C on his chest, and he's going to be able to play like a captain. I think he's a great leader. He's fucking hilarious. If you've seen any of his roast videos that he does on his Instagram story, like when he was recording Jalen, he's like, you tell me. He's hilarious, you know. I think a lot of guys look up to him. You know, you got TJ Yeldon and Corey Grant, who have been in the league longer than Leonard, but I still think kind of look up to Fournette, you know, and the playing style and how he plays football. So definitely a well-deserving captain. And last but not least, for the first time in his career, correct me if I'm wrong, I'm pretty sure this is the first time in his career, Blake Bortles is going to be named a captain for the 2018 season. That makes me so excited. That warms my heart. You know, it's just Tom Coughlin, this front office, Doug Marrone, all these guys really believe in Blake Bortles. And if you wanted a even more of a sign that they believe in Bortles, they named him a captain. And, you know, they're not just naming anybody captains. They're naming playmakers and, you know, guys that are leaders among the team. And, you know, if you think of leaders on the offense, you think Brandon Linder, Leonard Fournette, and Blake Bortles. Blake Bortles especially, who has stepped up this preseason. Prior to this preseason, I don't really remember much of seeing, like, pregame things where Blake would be talking to the team and, you know, trying to pump him up. I think he's kind of developed into that leadership role since his years in the NFL has developed, you know, trying to be the quarterback, trying to be a leader. I think that's something that maybe Tom Coughlin and Doug Marrone, you know, was trying to preach to Blake, saying, hey, man, you know, you need to go out there. You need to be a leader. We know you're soft-spoken. You don't let things get to you. But if you're going to be a quarterback in this league, you've got to be a captain. And, you know, he did a lot in the preseason as far as motivation goes, that I think he definitely deserves to be a captain. The guy just got paid. He's going to be the quarterback for the Jets for the next 3 years in the Super Bowl or bust 3 years. So I definitely think Blake Bortles is more than deserving of the captain title on his chest. And that was me breaking the news on the Jaguars' 5 captains this season. What do you guys think? Leave your comments down below. Don't forget to check the links down below as well. Don't forget to like me on Facebook at Treve Talks. Follow me on Twitter at Trevin Pixley, and follow me on Instagram at Trayvon Pixley. Also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, click the bell icon so you get notified every single time I drop a new video. I drop new Jaguar content on this channel 6 days a week. Ain't nobody outworking me. Them's just straight facts. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and as always, you guys have a great day.